Why is it that everything important that happens to you when you're a kid happens during the summer? In the summer of 1971, I was 10 years old, and the only thing I looked forward to more than the last day of school was the first day of practice of hydroplane racing season. You could say Madison kids were born into racing, the same way some folks were born in the oil business or farming. The townsport on the Ohio River at one point had been the busiest in the Midwest. But that had started to change. And though the river had given the town its prosperity, boat racing had given it her identity, having hosted the first professional boat race in the United States. The town even owned its own boat. They called it the Miss Madison. In June of 1961, my father climbed that very same boat, just 2 days after I was born, and barely survived a tragic accident which ended his racing career and took the life of his best friend. People used to say I should have known my father before the accident, that he was a different man. Well, that summer, 10 years later, he would give us a glimpse of just what kind of man he was.
She's not even hitting 110.
I guess we better check that compression tonight.
Gotta do better than that.
She's real sluggish. 1546.
How's she run, Dad?
Oh, yeah, a little slow on that one.
Probably supercharger backing down again.
Probably.
Damn things are just too unreliable.
Hey, watch your mouth.
Best first day we've ever had.
No. So the first day of 62, that was a whole lot smoother.
62? It rained that day.
Hello, everybody. Hey, Cecil.
Good morning, Mr. Mayor.
How are you?
Good.
Yeah, much better.
Look at those people, Tony. Best part of this day for me.
Starting to move, eh, Tony?
Yeah. Those nights in the garage last winter just might pay off.
Walker. What? Skip Dawn's pushing her too hard. I got me a bad feeling.
I told you 62 is better.
Now it's better, sure. But it still rained that day.
I'll get that fixed. I'll get it fixed. That'll be all right.
So. Well, let's tow her in.
Jimmy, let me give you a hand with that drill.
Hey, Tom, let's get these bugs out of here first.
Gotcha.
Okay, I'm out.
You haven't even gotten all your cards yet.
Well, I don't care. I'm out.
I mean, you want? You?
I think we're right.
Hey, everybody.
Hi, Mr. Mayor.
Present from Mabel over at the diner. Fried chicken.
All right, listen, you two. You can save your speeches because the answer is no.
Now, come on, Mayor. Now, we're only asking for a few $100.
Just in case of an emergency.
Every time you start that engine, there's an emergency. Look, it's out of my hands. You guys know I can't access municipal funds without a referendum or a two-thirds majority vote.
Boys, all in favor of accessing city funds for boat-related expenses, say aye.
Aye.
Looks like two-thirds to me.
I'll see what I can do.
There we go. That's the spirit. Hey, Jimmy, you got a second?
Read 'em and weep, gentlemen. The kid picked me a full house.
Oh. Didn't they pass your curfew, kid?
What's going on?
Well, you know, nothing's set in stone yet, but Helen and I are talking about moving up to Indianapolis.
Job offer come up?
No. It's just, I don't know. It's probably something I should have done a long time ago. But anyway, I guess it's pretty much up to you, but I was thinking that you're going to want to take over as crew chief.
I don't know. I mean, Bonnie's been after me to cut back on my boat hours, you know?
Jimmy, come on. You've driven these boats. You worked on these boats. You know this operation better than anybody.
Wow.
Dad, when you were driving, did you win a lot of races?
No, son, I never won any.
Do some of the teams bring people out to the races with them?
Sure. The bigger teams bring motorhomes full of people.
Kids, too? I can do stuff for the crew and everything. And
I know.
I haven't even been out of town before. Only to Grandma's house. That's really not that far.
Mm-hmm. Well, we'll have to check with the boss on this one, okay?
All right.
All right. Just don't tell her we had any of that chicken, okay?
Okay.
Here we go. So, Amy had a big day. Got home from work and I had the radio on. Was changing her diaper. And all of a sudden, out it came.
Out what came, honey?
Her first word.
At 11 months?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's incredible.
I know.
The little girl's a regular certified genius.
That's my girl.
Well, what does she say?
Agnew.
Agnew?
As in Spiro.
I know who the man is, Bonnie.
Who's Spiro Agnew?
This is gonna get around, you know.
Well, if you want, I can tell him she said his low-down crook in the same breath. Oh, come on, Jim. Look at his hands.
Mike asleep?
Mm-hmm, finally.
Mm.
Wanted to know what his first word was.
What was it? Nixon?
Close. It's Daddy.
Listen, honey. There's something I want to talk to you about. Walker and Helen are moving to Indianapolis, and he asked me to take over as team manager. It was completely unexpected.
You said yes?
I had to say yes.
How could you do that, Jim? How can you say it's unexpected, Jim? Walker's been looking for an excuse to get out of here for the last 5 years, and you know it. If we had any sense at all, Jim, we'd go too.
No, let's not get started.
Why,
on
Jim?
This.
We're getting in deeper and deeper. You know, how many people leave here before you see the writing on the wall?
And what wall is this? A wall from our house? How many homes do we own up in Indianapolis or Cincinnati?
How many jobs will we hold up there?
How many jobs did Owen have before he went to Chicago, Jim?
Now, that's really a fair comparison.
Jim, he invited you to partner with him.
Good night, Barney.
The forecast for tomorrow is warm and sunny. Perfect weather for all you racing fans. And who in this town isn't, come out and join us as we wish a fond, bon voyage to Miss Madison team. They load up and head off to the sunshine. Miami, first race of the season. We get pop up and usual appearance by Mayor Vaughn. Don't forget, listeners, it's your boat too.
Hey, Mayor.
A little something for the trip.
All right, Jimmy, I'm going to talk to you for a minute. Listen, this is just for an emergency, okay? Well, there's only about $200 in this account. It's the Women's Club five-county bake-off. But if old Mrs. Whittington finds out that we borrowed from her raspberry filling fund, we have to skin both our hineys.
I'll keep that in mind.
Put it up top.
Hi, honey.
Hi. I believe I approved this. You'd be good, all right?
No gambling, no whiskey, no winning.
Good luck.
Bye, Mom.
Every kid in Madison would have traded places with me that day. My father and the team were the only sports heroes we had, and now I was one of them.
Reset things so it won't run anymore.
Great, huh?
Oh, this is cool. Can I take a look around?
Sure. But don't run off too far. We have dinner plans tonight.
All right.
Hey, Tony.
You see that? The Atlas is going with a new hull this year. And look, who's that down there in Bill Muncie's boat?
I'll be. That's Buddy Johnson. He's a limited driver.
That's great. That's great, man.
He's supposed to be a real comer.
This huge shrimp completely sprayed this guy with his rooster tail. It was so funny.
Is that Grizzly Adams over there?
Yeah, that's Dan Haggerty. Who are you?
I'm Mike McCormick.
This picnic's only for racing teams.
Oh, I'm on the Miss Madison team.
Well, the food's over there.
Okay. And then the Miss Madison team.
Oh, hello, Mr. Waller. Oh,
well, hey, my God, it's the Budweiser team.
Hello, George.
I do, Roger.
Miss Madison. Rick.
So, how are the defending Gold Cup champions?
Well, if you can still lift that trophy at the end of the year, we'd be glad to take it from you again.
You win it, I'll lift it.
Hey, Roger.
Program.
Jim.
Hey, McCormick. Did you bring a calendar with you?
A what?
A calendar. Time that boat with.
Hey, old-timer. Why don't you pick on someone your own size?
How about this, Jimmy? How the hell are you?
Great, Harry.
And this can't be Mike.
Grown up some, hasn't he?
Certainly has. Why don't you come on board? Have a little fish.
Can you fish out of this boat?
Caught more fish than John the Baptist.
Who's John the Baptist?
Someone tells me this kid spends a little too much time at the boat garage.
Son, let me tell you something. Harry Volpe was as great a mechanic as they come. If your dad had walked out on that team in the middle of the season, we may have won a race or two.
That's not true. Your father is the only good thing about that entire group.
Well, I ran into Epperson and his smart aleck driver down at the registration tent.
I'll bet that made your day.
As always. If you'd like to come by later on, we sure could use an extra hand.
I think you know the answer to that.
Sunny day, a great day for the opening of the 1971 unlimited hydroplane racing season. Now the Madison local boys have been working all winter long to show well in this opening of the season. In a start unique to hydroplane racing, the clock starts to wind down as the drivers jockey for position. When the clock goes completely black, the drivers want their boat right at the starting line at full speed. Now, time and time again, Rick Winston, the Budweiser driver, has proven he's the sport's most talented stunt.
I came to race. Jesus, don't you guys have any pride?
I'll tell you what we do not have is another engine. That, thanks to you, we are dumb for the day. Do you understand?
Well, don't put that on me.
Like run, big
got
guy.
The lap in on him.
All right, you take a breather. We do it again.
All right.
You pull that old engine out of there, put the new one in for the next heat.
Let's move it. Heat two, boys.
You didn't hear?
Hear what?
Midwest Grain and Coal stopped all barge shipping.
Completely.
They're cutting half the shifts today. It's 372 men.
Come here, y'all. I want to show you something. This gear right here is an unlimited hydroplane.
Right.
Yeah.
If you have any more problems, just let me know, okay?
Now be
thank
careful,
you.
Take, come on. Isn't it great? Look at that guy in there. Kind of looks like your daddy, doesn't he, Mike? Come on, let's go inside. You guys are going to love this.
Everything in here is authentic. It's a real McCoy. All right, look here. This here boat raced in Madison 1928.
And then in 1958, millionaire Sam DuPont donated the current boat to the city, making the Miss Madison the world's only community-owned racing boat. Isn't that something? All that history right here in this little bitty town.
That is cool.
This is important for y'all to learn this stuff because we got a responsibility to keep this stuff going. Come here. Y'all, I want to show you something.
Need a lift?
Is
This the hearse? We ought to all be wearing dark glasses and using them seeing eye dogs for being so damn blind.
Bobby told me this morning. Any chance it's just a layoff?
No. Water transport's just too expensive. It's obsolete. This whole town's obsolete. Listen, Jim, Phyllis and I had a long talk this morning, and her brother has a lead on something for me up in Cincinnati. I just thought I ought to tell you, on account of the team and everything.
Sure. I appreciate that.
Real estate was weak before the layoffs. The issue is whether or not the housing market can support the turnover at all.
No one buys houses anymore. Everybody's leasing. It's just not practical.
So what do you suggest?
Maybe you should go see Owen next week when you're in Chicago.
You're something else, Bonnie.
What? He used to call all the time. Why not? Hear what he has to say.
Chicago.
Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town.
You did this. You requested this. Yes, you did.
No, I did not do that. I wish that I had, but I didn't.
Just go for a walk.
It's fate. Sunday couldn't shut down.
State Street, that great street.
I just want to say,
no.
They do things they don't do on Broadway.
It's a good thing you're handsome, sir.
They had the time of their life. I saw a man shoot his wife last night in Chicago. Chicago! That's my hometown.
How many people live here?
Give me just a little more time.
Good luck tomorrow.
Hey, Bobby. I got to run up and see an old friend tonight during the sponsors party. I was wondering if you could keep an eye on Mike for me.
Honestly, promised to stand in the drink lines for me.
Jimmy Mac, get your butt in here.
How you been, Owen? Oh, wow. Obviously pretty lousy.
Hey, you just missed Helen. She just dropped Ricky off.
Oh, here.
Hey, thanks, man.
Can't get over how big that lake is.
Oh, that's a clever gadget.
Oh, man, this thing will keep your beer cold all the live long day. Damnedest thing, man. I was down in Mexico, sales convention. I see this kid on the beach selling them for a nickel. Next thing I know, I'm in the sports marketing business.
Right place at the right time.
Story of my life. So, catch me up, man. My sister says to look for you on Wide World of Sports, and then I hear you're retired.
Yeah, well, after the accident, I got an offer to drive for a team out in Seattle, but, you know, moving to a new town and all would have taken some getting used to.
Hell, man. We got 3 new facilities opening next month. One in Newark, if you're looking around at all.
Well, we really love it back home, Owen. The regatta's coming up, and the trees along the river are in bloom.
No place like it. No place like it, I tell you.
I'll be
going on?
You guys want to go down to the docks and check out the boats?
Sure, come on, let's go.
The plane we flew on this time was a lot bigger than the plane we flew on to Miami. They even showed a movie, an R, too.
I've seen an R movie before. Our mall has 6 theaters in it, and we just sneak in.
They've shown an R at our town theater before.
You mean there's only one theater in your whole town?
Hey, let's go shoot bottle rockets off the pier.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay.
Well, the racing board has considered me and changed the circuit.
Being from San Diego, you know how important this is to me.
Well, with that great new waterway you guys are building, we're excited as hell to have you on board, George. Let's find your slot.
George, you know that my group is very serious. If we get behind this race, I can guarantee national TV.
He's right, George. Think about it. The APBA and the circuit stand to gain thousands of dollars.
All right, Bill, why don't you just tell me what works for you?
Well, first of all, we'll want the Labor Day weekend slot.
Madison's race?
Uh-huh.
Shoot, that means we'd have to kick them off the circuit, and they've been around a long time, 1904.
That has to be part of the deal. Sorry.
The guy from San Diego is Bill Kittle. Now, he's been trying to get a race on the circuit for years. And knowing how much money those guys are waving around, we're probably looking at our last season.
You mean we can't race anymore?
Just because we don't host a race don't mean we can't have the boat on the circuit, right?
Travis, proceeds from the regatta practically support the entire boat operation. Imagine George Wallen will make some sort of announcement tonight.
Hi, everybody. I'm George Wallen, president of the American Power Boat Association. If you don't know that by now, I'm in deep trouble. Unfortunately, Tri-Cities has had some sponsors fall through, and so they will be unable to host the Gold Cup Championship race this year. And we've decided, really, that the only fair thing to do is to conduct a drawing among the other 5 cities. And the city that is drawn will have the right to host this year's Gold Cup, provided, of course, they can guarantee the prize money, which is $50,000, to be deposited by tomorrow at midnight. And so, the city with the right to host the 1971 Gold Cup Championship race is Madison, Indiana. Well, will somebody from the Madison team come on?
Whole damn town isn't worth $50,000.
That's him. We can pick another card, you know, while everybody's still here. You understand that you're going to have to come up with this money by tomorrow.
Come on, get on with it. Pick somebody else.
The problem is getting the money by tomorrow may not work for us.
I didn't think it would.
You see, George, we'd like to deposit the money right now.
Jim, if you're looking at it, we're in enough of a tight crunch as it is, you know what I mean? I mean, if you're not really serious, you're wasting everybody's time. Let me just pick another card.
$50,000 and 0 cents.
See you in Madison, George.
Be the greatest news to hit Madison in years. Jimmy, you ought to think about running for mayor.
$50,000? Were you out of your mind?
Come on, let's get out with it.
Yeah, let's get out.
Come on. Folks, I called this meeting. I wanted to see where everybody stands on this issue.
Mr. Mayor, just in case you didn't know, last week 400 people lost their jobs. I'm one of them, and I say we forget about all this racing business.
And I say we stand behind Jimmy and the boys. That's easy for you to say. You work in Louisville.
Yeah, folks, I reckon we need to sell 25,000 regatta tickets to break even. Now, how many have we sold so far, Audrey?
Well, as of tonight, 134.
This whole thing's a joke.
Okay, folks, settle down.
No, that's
please.
Fine. I'm just
going to... All right. Folks, before you vote, Jim McCormick has a few words to say.
I know that this will be your decision, but I brought along a letter that the San Diego Racing Club sent to the American Powerboat Association last night. This letter is to protest the decision to allow Madison to host the Gold Cup. We are not alone in our belief that the championship race belongs in a major city, not in some backwoods town on a dirty river.
Backwoods town?
Dirty what?
As you know, the good people of San Diego.
There's no good sun making.
We'll show them what a real race looks like.
Right.
All in favor of hosting the Gold Cup, raise your hand.
Honey, I know what you're gonna say.
Something has to give.
Then let it give. I am not interested in becoming Styrofoam King in North America.
Well, I know that.
Those people back there are me. They were there for me after the accident, and I'm not turning my back on them now.
Get going tonight, Jimmy.
Thank you, Jake. Wait just a sec. I'll talk to you. Just a second.
We may need a little help from you folks down at the bank.
What kind of help?
That check of Wallen's. If you could buy us a week or two before it clears.
How am I gonna do that?
Good morning, Madison Bank and Trust.
Yeah, this is George Wallen, president of the American Powerboat Association, calling to find out when that $50,000 check's gonna clear.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wallen, you'll need to speak with Gertie, our check processor.
Well, put her on.
We do check processing on Tuesdays and Fridays.
What is this, Mayberry?
If you'd like, I can give Gertie your message tonight.
Tonight?
Yes, sir. At bingo.
Bingo. Never mind.
Audrey, how many can you get me from the women's club?
Okay, if you can do that, I would really appreciate
Jim.
It.
It's a real...
I gotta go. Right,
oh!
But...
One Bravo Delta, this is Central Station. You have to call. One Bravo Delta, come in, please.
Who is this?
It's Jim McCormick, Harry.
Yeah.
We're not getting enough power from our engines. And we really need the prize money in these next two races.
Yeah?
Well, I got to thinking
about your old nitrous oxide injection system.
Stay away from it, Jim.
Is any of that old equipment still around?
You know, if I couldn't do anything with that stuff with all of Epperson's money, you guys don't have a chance in hell. Jim, we're not talking about blowing up just boats and parts. We're talking about blowing up drivers.
I understand that, Harry. Listen. We put in a bid to host the Gold Cup.
Harry Volpe had pioneered the use of nitrous oxide injections for boat engines, and we were confident that this simple and straightforward device would be the answer to all our problems.
Does anybody recognize anything?
Where are the directions?
Stuff looks like scuba gear.
It's just engine equipment.
This is crazy. Harry Volpe's blown up more boats than the U.S. Navy.
Another picture-perfect day in Seattle, hydroplane fans, as the Miss Madison, racing here on Lake Washington, hope to overcome a tough start this season, and they hope that the momentum of Madison being the host city for the 1971 Gold Cup will do it for them.
Go Cup tickets. Sir? Ma'am?
Injection system checks out.
Yep, canisters are mounted. She's ready to go.
Jim, come here. I think we got a handle on that nitrous system. We
When you get in open water, go ahead and hit that white button. You get a boost of power.
Anything you guys can do to make this tub go faster, I'm all for it.
Gold cup tickets. Get them now. Gold cup tickets. Get them now. They're going fast. Get your gold cup tickets.
Look here. Moonhead's trying to get people to come to his hillbilly cup.
I'll see you selling any gold cup tickets, Epperson.
I guess I will be soon, since I heard that we're hosting the gold cup since you guys haven't sold enough tickets yet.
That's a lie.
George Wallen's talking to my dad about it right now. Why don't we just go over there and ask him?
You're so full of it.
Want to do something about it? That's what I thought. A chicken. Just like his dad. Let's go.
After a broken delay, time starts. Skip Naughton steers the Miss Madison through the first turn, right in the middle of the pack.
That's a 14-6 on that first corner, Jim. Winston trying to take the inside.
All right, she's looking good.
Coming off the fourth quarter, the Miss Madison is really moving, fans. Only a boat length out of the lead.
He could use it on this stretch.
Skip Naughton is driving a great race, a beautiful race, as he brings her down the main straight.
Come on, Skip, let's go.
He seems to be okay, but he's swimming away from a burning, sinking boat.
Get those hillbillies off the water!
Skip, listen, I thought we had a handle on it. I apologize, really.
Mechanics who know what they're doing have a hard enough time with this stuff, let alone a gas pump or a dock worker and some retard. I quit.
The drive from Seattle took almost 3 days, but it felt like 3 years. We returned on a bleak Saturday afternoon. My father and I had barely spoken during the trip, already aware what this would mean to the team and the town.
I'm heading down to the boat garage if you want to come.
No.
Come on. Let's go for a ride.
Come on, there's something I want to show you. It's just up here.
You brought me up here to see a cave?
Not just any cave, son. Brought me down here when I was a little boy. Showed me what stalactites look like. Claimed he discovered this place when he was in high school. Told me I was the only person that ever told about it. Something else, huh? Here, take a look at this. My dad would have tanned my hide if he had ever seen this. I used to come up here sometimes when I need to think about things. It's one of the special things about where we live. It just occurred to me today that you've never been here.
Hey, Lyle, I'm sorry. I tried to call you last week, but we had a problem out in Seattle. I'll talk to you later.
I'll call you right back. Jim!
Yeah?
We need to talk.
Patty said they might be looking for someone over at Meacham's.
What, you tell her about this already?
No, I didn't tell her about this already. I wouldn't do that.
I'm sorry.
You know, Jim, this may be for the best. At least it's a fresh start, you know? I know Bobby and Tony will miss you, but they just have to understand.
I can't do that, Bonnie. That boat's all this town's got.
Jim, what are you saying? You saying that this doesn't change anything?
Why are we stopping here?
Get out of the car, Jim.
What?
Get out of the car.
Bonnie, for crying out loud.
I told you before you had a choice to make. It's pretty clear to me you've already made it. Go!
Okay.
I'll dream.
I know. Just stopping for gas.
Batting cages!
No, I'm sorry. We're an hour from Grandma's, Mike. You know what a mom's seen those places were the last time we came through here. No. Can you just fill it up for me, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
Back in the car, sweetie.
7/16, okay.
7/16.
Travis,
sorry.
Travis, would you watch where you're going? That could really hurt somebody.
All right, I think I might go to Shipley's and get me some coffee or something.
What?
Honey? Bonnie?
Y'all on lunch break?
Beyond repair.
Long night in front of us, then.
It's already been a long night. Nothing more we can do.
It's totaled. We need boat builders, not mechanics.
Well, I'll just find somebody and fix it.
I already called someone. Staudaker up in Michigan. $6,000 for 4 weeks at least.
Then I'll get Peter or somebody to work on it.
Jim, you're not listening to me. It's destroyed.
Don't tell me I ain't listening. After all we've been through to get this far, and you're ready to just throw it away.
Why don't you just get off your high horse, McCormick? Just a damn boat.
If that's the way you feel about it, then maybe you should have taken that great, fancy, high-class job up in Cincinnati.
Maybe I should have.
You've had a rough couple of days, Jimmy. I think maybe we all ought to get a little sleep.
There's a reason they call them the good old days. What a time. Going every weekend from race to race with Davey and Linda and everybody. It seemed like such an adventure for a while. Stupid. Soon it was races on Sundays, funerals on Tuesdays. Sometimes a man we barely knew. Sometimes a friend. And Davey. It's still in his blood, isn't it? Good night, sweetheart. Good night, Mom.
Tomorrow's the deadline for covering the check, and, well, we weren't even close. There's about $12,000 in there. I'm sorry.
Come on in, Jim. I'll make you a black cow.
As far as the boat goes, we're done for the season. Probably for good. I take full responsibility for that. Sure is calm tonight.
The plain fact is that if it hadn't been for a couple of misguided Indians, none of us would be here anyway. Supposedly, they were paddling upstream from Kentucky, and they settled here because they thought they were in Cincinnati. Next thing you know, we're the busiest port outside New Orleans, wealthiest town in the state.
I remember when I was a little boy, my dad and I used to sit down there on the shore and count all the boats coming in and out of the port.
Everybody nowadays will tell you they saw it coming. But back then, Nobody could ever imagine what this river would look like without all those boats going up and down. Maybe those Indians should have built this town on a superhighway. I guess we should have realized it was only a matter of time before boat racing outgrew us too.
I'm sorry for waking you up.
You didn't wake me up.
Well, for those 24 hours, it seemed like every person in town came to the team's aid.
Now it's Tuesday, and I want to talk to Gertie.
I'm sorry, Mr. Wallen. She had to run to her grandson's piano recital.
Oh, this is ridiculous. Get me the bank president.
He's at the recital also.
Who is this kid, Vladimir Horowitz?
No, sir. Richie McAllister. There are no Vladimirs in Madison, as far as I know. Have a nice day.
Darlene, you think they'd let an old fat guy be an astronaut?
Sir?
If I do something stupid and get voted out of office, I'd have to come up with something else, right?
Hello? Hello?
Oh, afternoon, Miss McCormick.
Hi.
I hope you don't mind we come back here. Well, we heard from some folks down there at Shipley's that Jim wasn't gonna be able to finish us. Do the boat now.
So he didn't know you're here?
No, ma'am.
Well, let me get you guys some pop or something.
This boat's gonna be in the water wherever the heck the Gold Cup is.
Hey, Jimbo.
Yeah?
You got a phone call here. It's Jake Merrill over at the bank.
Uh-oh.
Hey, Jake.
Hey, Jim, have you talked to the mayor?
Yeah, I talked to him last night. I was at his house.
So you know he covered the check?
What?
$50,000.
He did what?
Yeah, from the city's sanitation funds.
Listen, I gotta go. I gotta get to the ticket office. Okay, bye. Okay,
Tony, call this guy Buddy Johnson. See if he's available to race for us.
What for?
We got the gold cup.
No,
we got the gold cup.
Wait, what?
We may not have our garbage collected for the next 3 years, but we got the gold cup.
We got it. Let's go call.
Good morning, Madison.
It floats.
Yeah.
Excuse me. What's going on?
Oh, it floats. Isn't that great?
Hey, your buddy. In the flesh, oh. Mr. McCormick.
Hey, oh, God, I'm sorry. We were just testing the boat out here. Well, here, meet my wife, Bonnie. And it's Jim, by the way.
How are you? This is my new bride, Tammy.
Oh, newlyweds. Congratulations. 6 weeks.
Well, come on, buddy. Let me introduce you to Miss Madison.
Oh, she is an angel.
So I hear you're going to be driving for Atlas Van Lines in Dayton this weekend.
Yeah, they only need me for one race, so I'll be available for the Gold Cup.
Well, Atlas is a damn fine operation. You're going to have some excellent equipment underneath you.
Yeah, I can't hardly wait.
Yeah. Well, let me just tell you a little bit about this boat. Go ahead and hop in there, buddy. She's 12 years old. She's heavy, and she's gonna handle a whole lot different than anything you've ever piloted. I'm just telling you, because we just rebuilt the whole right sponson on her. The engine is down on horsepower, and, well, frankly, buddy, we really don't know what she's got left in her.
Tell you what, Jim. As long as she floats and her engine runs, I'll put her at the front of the pack.
Zephyr was great. Thanks again.
You're welcome. I'm glad you
enjoyed it. Good luck with the Atlas. See you Tuesday?
Yeah.
Great. See you next week.
All right, you betcha, boss.
Bye.
Hey, come. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo!
Oh, he's a stick of dynamite.
Years ago, I knew a guy like that.
Well, let's see if I can still try here.
Oh, wait a minute. No, I come back.
With a new driver and restored boat, the mood in the town was high. But things were different with me. And none of that seemed to matter anymore.
Making his first appearance here in Dayton is limited class driver Buddy Johnson in the Atlas Van Lines boat. Although he's driving for Atlas today, Buddy will be the driver for the Madison team in next week's Gold Cup championship.
Madison, we got a ticket office.
Hey, Jim.
Hey, Andre.
We got the race, huh?
Great, thank you.
Hi,
Andre. How's the ticket sales coming along?
It's all right. Bit of an upswing this week, but... We need a lot of walk-ups. We're in big trouble.
The final heat's starting.
Thank you.
The boats charging toward the starting line, deck to deck.
Come on, buddy.
Budweiser and Cat's Pride on the inside.
Can
you see? Then the right there. On the outside. And young he's racing Johnson. For Atlas this week.
The Atlas boat is on a far outside.
Let's go.
They hit the start, and the race... Oh, an accident! My God, an accident on the course! It's the Atlas Van Lines boat. The Atlas has flipped on the course. Buddy Johnson's boat.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God, what a tragic accident this will be. Buddy Johnson, 22 years old, the sport's most prominent up-and-coming driver from the limiting class. See him there on the stretcher, and he'll be a living helicopter. See you next week.
see the rest of your teams here are on the course. This young wife is looking on. Oh, God, what she must be feeling. Her thoughts.
Up there. I knew what you were doing.
I owe it to them, Bonnie.
Who do you owe? The team? The town? Who, Buddy?
Buddy has nothing to do with this.
Who then? Davey? Is this your way of asking for his forgiveness? You think Davey wants you to go out there and kill yourself? You don't owe anyone.
For 8 years, I've been trying to explain to people what I was thinking when I walked away from that cockpit in the middle of the season. And for 8 years, I've been trying to convince them that it was because of Epperson or because of Davy's crash or because of you. And all along, I've known it didn't have anything to do with anybody but me.
Jim.
Now, hold on a second. Maybe I didn't have the guts to keep racing for the same reason that I do not have the guts to leave here.
It's not fair.
I'm gonna do it, Bonnie.
Waiting on the caboose. Wait, you guys.
One Bravo Delta, this is Central Station. You got another one.
McCormick, you know, this is really becoming ridiculous.
Harry, it's Bonnie.
What's wrong?
Welcome to Madison, Indiana, folks. Proud home of the Miss Madison team. Thank you for joining us as we host the Gold Cup for the first time in the town's history. Please watch your step as you disembark. And don't forget to buy your tickets for the big race tomorrow. You can find them in the gold and red booths to your right. On behalf of the Belle of Hope, we hope you enjoy your stay here in Madison.
Hey, Harry. What the heck are you doing up here?
How about that, huh? I should have just moved my boat up here and retired. Got a hell of a lot of more fishing in, I'll tell you that. Don't we call that dirt, son? You're gonna have to rewash every one of these.
Okay.
No, not okay. Do it.
Okay.
Mr. Volpe, it's a pleasure.
Oh, sir, how are you?
Tony Steiner.
You can call me Harry, Tony.
You got it. I was going over this blower assembly.
I'll tell you right off, you're going to want to recheck the clearance on this one.
Will do.
Good attitude. I like it. Roberto, a face from the past.
It's been a long time, Harry.
Sure has. That's looking real good.
Damn right it does.
Attaboy.
Harry, about the nitrous system.
No nitrous now, son. It's out of the question. You're going to want to disassemble this entire engine while I go out and find myself something to eat. I'll be back in an hour or two.
I don't know how you heard, Harry, but thanks.
I got a hunch you do. You know the first thing the big fish tell the little baby fish? Don't ever eat anything hanging on a string off a dock. Let's go fishing. Let me see your cast. That a boy. The man can cast. Haven't been helping your dad out too much lately, have you?
What's it gonna matter? People will still laugh at us.
People? You mean the people on the other teams? It'd be nice, wouldn't it, if we could change places with other people? You know, kind of wake up one day and live in a different place, big house and fancy parents. That'd really be swell, wouldn't it?
We wouldn't lose anymore.
No, and you wouldn't have to work at it anymore either, would you? You think your dad and the team would like it that way? There's nobody that works harder at this game than the boys in that garage.
Then we should be winning.
Well, yes, sir, I guess we should, but every now and then, a pocket full of money will whoop the pants out of plain old hard work. You got something?
Go on.
Attaboy, you're a fisherman. You're a fisherman. Hey, Jim.
Yeah.
You want to go out to my truck and get the socket wrench?
Sure. Wait a minute. Your truck? You didn't drive your truck.
Now, if you weren't so damn tired, you'd have figured that out before you even went out there.
Come on, Harry. You're shorthanded as it is.
We got 10 hours to get that engine running right.
Go to sleep.
All right, well, I'm going.
Well, I got that breather hose off the accessory housing. So where do we go next, you think?
Next place. Oh, McCormick. I told you to go home and get some sleep. Thank you.
Hey, Jimbo! Big day for you tomorrow.
Big day for all of us.
Listen, Jimmy, don't worry too much about the race. Just coax her through a couple of laps. We'll all be proud. See you tomorrow.
I see why this nitrous system ain't gonna work. Your motor just plumb wore out. Yeah, if these parts are shot.
Maybe we should get some new ones.
There aren't many World War II airplane engines available in southern Indiana at this hour.
Hey, maybe we ought to drive to Columbus and steal the engine from that old fighter plane from City Hall.
Now, hold on a second here.
I'll do it.
I'm in.
Fellas, even if there is still an engine in it, which it probably isn't, we're talking about a plane on display down in front of their City Hall. It's in the mayor's office, the county jail.
I don't think there's much left here to discuss, do you?
We can take my truck.
Well, I was just kidding.
Please don't look at me like that. You want to do old Harry a favor? Go home, get some sleep. I need you in the morning to be sharp.
Back tomorrow around noon. Won't be as bright.
Here, no, let me get that. Okay. All right. Okay. What do you got there?
It's the tack drive.
You got it?
I can't get in there. If you just. Had somebody with smaller
hands?
Will I be?
It's not smoke, that's steam.
Wow. Have you ever been on it?
Sure, loads of times. They're giving rides all day. I can get you on if you want.
Cool.
Let's go.
Wait, my dad said we could watch TV in his new motorhome. Guys?
Hey, Jim. Jim, I hear you guys only sold 30,000 tickets.
Well, George, we're counting on a few walk-ups.
What is ABC going to say when they see a half-empty showroom?
I suppose we'll find out.
I knew this was a mistake. That everyone would come to this place.
The banks of the Ohio River as it flows by the city of Madison, Indiana. Population about 13,000 on a hot summer day.
It's the setting today with more about 100,000 people.
To watch the Gold Cup race or unlimited hydroplanes. It's an American folklore festival where thousands and thousands have come to enjoy themselves and just have some fun.
Hello, I'm Keith Jackson, and you're about to see today on ABC's Wide World of Sports what we call the Thunderboats, the unlimited hydroplanes, the
powerhouses of boat racing, run for the Gold Cup. This is the Grand Prix for the unlimited hydroplanes. This is the one that every man in boat racing strives to win at one time or another, because this is the top prize. Race is set up on a point system. We'll run five heats today, and the five boats with the most points will advance to the winner take all final. The heavy favorite today is Rick Winston in Miss Budweiser. He's gunning for his third straight Gold Cup trophy, and he's piloted his boat to four wins in five races so far this year.
Winston!
Jimmy, that Jimmy, no!
Was no accident.
You know it! Jimmy, he's, come on now, he's not perfect.
McCormick.
Jim!
It's racing.
I'm gonna show you racing!
Let it
come
go
on.
And stay focused!
Our previous heat had to be stopped shortly after the start because of an accident that occurred in the first turn. The Hallmark Holmes boat sank. It's now at the bottom of the Ohio River. We'll be back for the running of the next heat in just a moment.
second or third in this heat puts us in the final.
Well, then I'm going to really get out the pusher.
Oh, no, 3,700 RPMs. That's all the posting engine.
How do you expect me to beat these guys? Three-quarters throttle.
You're the driver. Figure it out.
As the heat gets underway, Miss Madison has a big problem falling well off the pace.
Come on, Dad, pick it up.
Miss Madison is lagging way behind the other leaders, almost a half lap.
Something's got to be wrong.
Right on it.
Up at the front, Fayette back, coming hard, taking the lead. But look, there's a puff of smoke. That's a full engine, no question. Fayette back's gone, coasting off the course.
With the Payette Pack out, third is all we need. We're in the final heat.
We're in, guys. We're in, Harry.
Just hope that he can hold together and finish, son.
This could be the miracle the Madison team was hoping for, but Madison's got trouble. They are down on power. It's a struggle right now.
Just hold together and finish.
Come on, baby.
Here comes Madison, smoke billowing out of the engine now. Will she make it? Can she make it? Across the line, McCormick's done it. The Madison is in the championship heat.
Congratulations on putting the Miss Madison in the final heat of a Gold Cup race for the first time ever.
Well, thank you. The guys have been working awfully hard, and it's a tribute to them that we're in it.
Budweiser and the Atlas are the heavy favorites. You've run against them both today. Who do you give the edge to?
Well, I'd like to think that we'll have a say in that.
Is the Madison strategy to simply stay out of the way and hope to be running at the finish?
Hell no. We're out there to win just like everybody else.
That's the spirit, Jim. All right, fellas, let's go get set up in the Budweiser pit.
I gotta talk to you about this final.
I don't want to go home early.
I don't know, Jimmy.
You heard me, Harry. We're not just showing up today.
You're dragging a stick of dynamite.
What else do you have?
Want to go get your drill bit box?
Isn't that one awful big for the nitrous?
But Jim, no.
This is my decision, guys. We're gonna go, we're gonna blow.
Listen to me. That white button, only push that if you're still racing.
You got me? Ought to call her to Miss Hindenburg.
Spot in 15 minutes. Mm-hmm. Easy now. I don't want you to be all smudged up for the TV cameras. We're gonna win. Mm-hmm. We're gonna win for all of us.
Hey, Jim.
I gotta go.
Let's do it.
I gotta go.
Yeah.
you doing?
He's gonna be fine.
Thank you.
Jimmy, congratulations. Never won one before, and you won the big one in front of the home.
Thank you, Keith. Well, we really wanted it.
Well, you guys were just sitting there quietly watching everybody
walk away, and then all of a sudden, you're in the driver's seat.
We were going to go. We were going to blow, Keith. God, I'm just so proud of this team and this town.
Well, God bless you. Thanks, Jim. And here comes his wife, Bonnie.
How about that, honey?
Take a look over here.
Bring it on. Present the 1971 Gold Cup Award to Mr. Jim McCormick and the Miss Madison team.
The citizens of Madison kept their spot on the racing circuit. Now it's one of the most popular tourist towns in the Midwest. The Miss Madison team is still racing on the Unlimited Circuit, although they haven't won a race since 1973. My father once said that only someone who had raced competitively could understand why so many men had given their lives to the sport of boat racing. My father continued racing until 1975. When an accident forced him to retire from the circuit altogether. He remained a fixture in the sport and in Madison until his death in 1996. That following summer, I began racing on the Unlimited Circuit. I dedicate each race to his memory.